Problems on groups, part 8. Let us define what is an idempotent element. If A is an element in a group G such that A into A is equals to A, then A is said to be an idempotent element. If the operation is a multiplication, this becomes A squared is equals to A. If the operation is addition, then A plus A equals to A. In this case, we say the element A is an idempotent element. Show that in a group G, for A comma B belong to G, AB whole squared is equals to A squared into B squared if and only if G is abelian. Solution: let G be a group. A comma B belong to G and AB whole squared is equals to A squared B squared. Now we have to show that the group G is abelian. We are given that AB whole squared is equals to A squared B squared. This implies AB whole squared can be written as AB into AB. This A squared can be written as A into A. This B squared can be written as B into B. This by law of indices. Now we can write the above expression as A into BAB is equals to A into ABB. Because this is a group, associative law satisfies. Now, using left cancellation law, we can cancel this A on the left hand side, this A on the right hand side. But this A lie the left of BAB and ABB. So by using left cancellation law, we can write the above expression is equals to BAB equals to ABB. Now using associative property. This can be written as BAB can be written as BA into B. ABB can be written as AB into B. Now we are going to use the right cancellation law. Using right cancellation law, this B can be cancelled. Therefore, BA is equals to AB. By using right cancellation law, thus G satisfies the commutative property, namely AB equals to BA, therefore G is abelian. Now let us prove the converse part. Conversely, let G be an abelian group. We have to show that AB whole squared is equal to A squared B squared. Let us start with AB whole squared. AB whole squared can be written as AB into AB using law of indices. By associative property, we can write A into BA into B. Since G is abelian, this BA can be written as AB. Now, again using associative law, we can write AA into BB. What is A into A? By laws of indices, A into A is A squared. What is B into B? B into B is B squared by law of indices. Therefore, AB whole squared is equal to A squared B squared. Using this can be written as A into B into B using associative law. What is A into A? A into A is A squared, B into B is B squared by law of indices. Therefore, AB whole squared is equals to A squared B squared. Thus, AB whole squared is equals to A squared B squared if and only if G is abelian. Another problem, if every element of the group G is its own inverse, then show that G is an abelian. Solution: let G be a group and every element in G has its own inverse. Now we have to show that G is abelian. That is, AB is equals to B into A for all A comma B belong to G. Let A belong to G. What is given? every element in G has its own inverse. Therefore, we can write A equal to A inverse. And B belongs to G. Since every element has its own inverse, B belongs to G implies B inverse is equals to B. This is by the hypothesis and call them as one. Let A comma B belong to G. Since A comma B belong to G, by closure property A into B also belongs to G. Now A into B is a single element which belongs to G. Since every element in G has its own inverse, AB has inverse and its inverse is equal to itself, namely AB. Therefore, we can write AB equal to AB whole inverse. Now let us consider AB equal to AB whole inverse. What is AB whole inverse? By reversal law, AB whole inverse is B inverse into A inverse. What is B inverse? B inverse is B by 1. What is A inverse? A inverse is A by 1. Therefore, we can write B into A using 1. Thus, AB equals to BA for all A comma B belong to G. Therefore, we say G is abelian. In a group G, for every A belongs to G such that A squared is equals to E, then show that G is an abelian group. Or prove that a group G is abelian if every element of G except the identity is of degree 2. Because when you say A squared is equal to E, E is an identity element and this 2 is known as order of the element A. Solution: let A comma B belong to G. This implies since in every element A such that A squared equal to E, therefore A belongs to G means A squared equal to E, B belongs to G implies B squared equal to E. A squared is equals to E. This implies A into A by law of indices is equals to E. That means the inverse of A is itself. Here AB equal to E, this B, in the place of B we have a A. And hence this is the inverse of A, therefore A inverse equal to A. Similarly, B squared equal to E, this B squared can be written as B into B equal to E. Therefore, the inverse of B is B. And hence, every element has its own inverse. Therefore, A comma B belong to G implies AB belong to G by closure law. Therefore, AB belongs to G implies by hypothesis A squared belong, AB whole squared is equals to E. Consider AB whole squared equal to E. What is AB whole squared? AB whole squared is AB into AB. This is by law of indices, that is equals to E. That is, now multiply both sides by AB inverse. That is, post multiplied by AB whole inverse. Now consider AB, AB whole inverse. This is one element, this is its inverse. Therefore, we know that A into A inverse is equals to E. Therefore, this product becomes E now, identity. Therefore, AB into identity is simply AB. So, AB into E into AB inverse is AB inverse because this E is the identity. And hence, AB equals to AB inverse. This by reversal law, AB inverse can be written as B inverse, A inverse. What is B inverse? B. What is A inverse? A. And hence AB equal to BA for all A comma B belong to G. Or once we come to know A squared equals to E implies A inverse equal to A, B squared equal to E implies B inverse equals to B. That is, A and B are two arbitrary elements, and from this we say that every element has its own inverse. Hence, by the previous problem, we can conclude that the group G is abelian without writing all these steps. Hence, G is abelian if G is a group such that AB whole power m is equals to A to the power m into B to the power m for 3 consecutive integers of m for all A comma B belong to G, then prove that G is an abelian group. Let A comma B belong to G. Let m plus 1, m plus 2 be 3 consecutive integers. By hypothesis, AB whole power m is A to the power m into B to the power m. What's the next integer? M plus 1. Therefore, by hypothesis, we can write AB whole to the power m plus 1 is equal to A to the power m plus 1 into B to the power m plus 1. The next consecutive integer is m plus 2. That is AB whole power m plus 2 is equal to A to the power m plus 2, B to the power m plus 2. This is given to us. Now we have to show that G is abelian. For that, choose any two arbitrary elements, A and B, all you have chosen. Now our aim is to show that AB is equals to BA. Let's consider AB whole to the power m plus 2 equal to A to the power m plus 2 into B to the power m plus 2. That is, start with this equation number 3. Now, this AB whole to the power m plus 2 can be written as AB whole to the power m plus 1 into AB. This is the one here. Similarly, A to the power m plus 2 can be written as A to the power m plus 1 into A, B to the power m plus 1 into B. This is by law of indices. Now, using equation number 2, AB whole to the power m plus 1 can be written as A to the power m plus 1 into B to the power m plus 1. This is AB. That is equals to A power m plus 1, A, B power m plus 1 into B. Simply, we have used equation number 2 here. Using left cancellation law, this A to the power m plus 1, here A to the power m plus 1 get cancelled. Similarly, by right cancellation law, this B and this B get cancelled. Therefore, we get B to the power m plus 1 into A equals to A into B to the power m plus 1 using left cancellation law and right cancellation law. Now, multiply both sides by A to the power m. That's called pre-multiplication. A to the power m. Here also A to the power m. Now this B to the power m plus 1 can be written as B to the power m into B. Here this A to the power m into A can be written as A to the power m plus 1. Therefore this is A to the power m. B to the power m plus 1 into A is Bm into B into A. Here A to the power m into A is A to the power m plus 1 into B to the power m plus 1. Using 1 and 2, this is 1, this is 2. This A power m into B to the power m can be written as AB whole to the power m. This A to the power m plus 1, B to the power m plus 1 can be written as AB whole to the power m plus 1. Therefore, this is AB whole power m into BA. This can be written as AB whole to the power m plus 1. Again, in the right hand side, we can write AB whole to the power m plus 1 as AB whole to the power m into AB using law of indices. Now, using left cancellation law, we can cancel AB whole to the power m and AB whole to the power m. Hence, we get BA equals to AB. This is by left cancellation law. Thus, G satisfies commutative property. Hence, the algebraic structure G, multiplication is an abelian group. Thus, any group satisfying AB whole square equal to A power m into B to the power m for any 3 consecutive integers of m, then G is an abelian group. Next, we define what is an order of an element. Order of an element in a group. Let G, circle be a group. and A be any element of G, then the order of the element A is defined as the least positive integer n, such that A to the power n is equals to E. Here the very important point is n is the least positive integer. We denote the order of an element A by O of A or modulus of A. Generally we use O of A. If there exists no positive integer n such that A to the power n is equal to E, then the order of A is defined to be either 0 or infinity. Note, the order of the identity element E is 1. In any group, the order of the identity element is always 1. And we know that inverse of the identity element is itself. If the algebraic structure G comma plus is a group, here we defined for multiplication. Suppose the operation is the addition, then this formula A to the power n is equal to E. This expression A to the power n is equal to E can be written as n into A equals to E. Because what is A power n? We have to write A n times. A into A into A into A into A n times. Here what is n into A? N into A is A plus A plus A plus A plus n times. So here if it is a multiplication, write the power. If it is addition, write the multiplication. N into A equal to E, where N is the least positive integer, then N is the order of the element A, that is order of A is N. So remember that if it is a multiplication, use this expression A to the power N equal to E. If the operation is addition, we have to use the expression N into A equals to E. Example, find the order of each element of the group G, which contains the elements 1, omega, omega square. We know that 1 is the identity element. Before we find the order of any element, we should know what is the identity element in the group. Because whether it is a multiplication or addition, we need E. Right hand side we have E. Therefore, here 1 is the identity element. Now we have to use the expression A to the power n equal to E, because here we know that this is a multiplicative group. What is number 1? Number 1 is the identity. As we know that order of the identity element is always 1. Therefore, order of 1 is 1. Now we have to find the order of omega. That is, omega power some integer is equals to 1. It is not some integer. Omega to the power the least positive integer must be equals to 1. We know omega power 1 is not equal to 1. Omega power 2 is also not equal to 1. But omega power 3 is 1. Therefore, omega power 3 equal to 1, and hence order of omega is 3. What about omega square? Omega squared power 1 is omega squared, which is not identity. Omega power 2 to the power 2 is omega power 4. We know that omega power 3 is 1, so omega power 4 is omega. It is not identity. Omega squared power 3 is omega power 3 into whole squared. Omega power 3 is 1, therefore 1 squared is 1, and hence order of omega squared is 3. That's the one written here. Omega squared power 3 is omega power 3 into 1. For what is omega power 3? Omega power 3 is 1. 1 is the identity. 1 squared is 1. Therefore, order of omega squared is 3. Hence, order of 1 is 1, because 1 is the identity. Order of omega is 3. Order of omega squared is also 3. Find the order of each element of the multiplicative group 1 minus 1 I minus I. We know that 1 is the identity of G. Since here is a multiplicative group, we have to use A to the power n is equals to E. Now, consider the element 1. 1 is the identity element whose order is always 1. And hence we can write 1. Now we have to find the order of minus 1. Minus 1 to the power least positive integer must be equals to 1. What is that number? It is clearly 2. Similarly, the order of I is 4 and the order of minus I is also 4. Find the order of each element of the group G, addition modulo 6. Solution: given G equals to the set containing elements 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and the algebraic structure G, addition modulo 6 is a group. Here E is the identity element, and we know that the inverse of the identity element is itself, and the order of the identity element is 1, and hence the order of 0 is 1. This is the one order of 0. Now the definition says that if G comma plus is a group, A belongs to G, and N into A equal to E. Here the expression is N into A equal to E, where N is the least positive integer, then N is the order of the element A. Now choose A equal to 1. Now N into A equal to E means A plus A plus A plus A equal to E, where A equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and the identity is 0. Okay, fine. Now we are going to find the order of 1. Then take A equal to 1. 1 plus 1 equal to 0? No, because 1 plus 1 is 2. When 2 is divided by 6, the answer is 2. What about 1 plus 1 plus 1? 1 plus 1 plus 1 is 3. When 3 is divided by 6, the answer is 3, because this sum is less than 6. What about 4? No, because 4 is divided by 6, the answer is 4, not equal to 0. What about 5? No. 6? Yes. 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 is 6. When 6 is divided by 6, the remainder is 0. Yes, it is. Therefore, the order of 1 is 6. We have to write 1 6 times. That is 6 into 1 is 0. That is equals to order of 1 is 6. Now let us find order of 2. We have to write 2 as many times as till you get the answer is 0. What about 2 plus 2? No. But 2 plus 2 plus 2 is 6. When 6 is divided by 6, the remainder is 0. Therefore, order of 2 equal to 3. See, when you add the integers, the sum must be either 6 or multiples of 6. It must be 6 or 12 or 18 or 24, like this. When you have the sum 6 or 12 or 18 or 24, you can stop it. Till then you have to add that element. Now what about 3? 3 plus 3, 9. No. 3 plus 3 plus 3. 3 threes are 9. Now we are going to find the order of 3. What is 3 addition modulo 6, 3? 3 plus 3 is 6. Yeah, sum is 6. When 6 is divided by 6, the remainder is 0. Therefore, order of 3 is 2. What about the order of 4? 4 plus 4 is 8. Is not a multiple of 6. 3 times, when you add 3 times, 4 plus 4 plus 4. 4 plus 4 is 8, 8 plus 4 is 12. Yes, 12 is a multiple of 6. And hence, 4 plus 4 plus 4, you have to write 3 times. And hence, 12 by 6, the remainder is 0. Therefore, order of 4 is 3. Now, what about 5? How many times you have to write 5 to get the sum 6 or multiples of 6? 5 plus 5 is 10. 3 5s are 15. 4 5s are 20. No. 5 5s are 25. No. 6 5s are 30. 30 is a multiple of 6. Therefore, we have to write 5 6 times. And hence, order of 5 is 6. A theorem: the order of every element of a finite group is finite, and it is less than or equal to the order of the group. It has two parts. The first part is order of every element of your finite group is finite. The group is finite, therefore order of every element must be finite. The second part is order of any element must be less than or equal to order of the group G. Proof: let G comma dot be a finite group. Here taken the operation is the multiplication. We have to show that order of A is finite. Let A belong to G. Then by closure property, A into A is A squared belongs to G. A squared into A is A cubed belongs to G. A cubed into A is A power 4 belongs to G. So on. And it will be having infinitely many elements here. A squared, A power 3, A power 4. So on. Go on. We will get all these are all elements of G. Since G is closed. But what is G? G is a finite group. But this collection has infinite number of elements. See, this A squared, A power 3, A power 100, A power 1 lakh, so on. They are all elements of G. Here we have infinitely many elements. But what is G? G is finite. How can it be possible? Therefore, all the integral powers of A, namely A squared, A power 3, A power 4, so on, cannot be distinct elements of G. Suppose order of G is 20. Then this will be having infinitely many numbers. What about the rest of the numbers? They all equal in some or other way. Therefore, since G is finite, all the integral powers of A cannot be distinct elements of G. Let us consider A to the power R equal to A to the power S, where R and S belong to N, natural number, and assume that R is greater than S. You can also take S is greater than R, nothing wrong in it. Now, multiply both sides by A to the power minus S, because A power S is belongs to G, and G is a group, therefore inverse X is for every element. Therefore, A to the power S belongs to G implies A power minus S also belongs to G, and hence there exists A power minus S, and let us multiply with A power minus S. This can be written as A to the power R minus S, law of indices. A to the power S minus S, we know S minus S is 0, A power 0 is identity. Therefore, we can write A to the power R minus S is equals to, this is nothing but identity. What does it mean? This means A to the power M equal to E, where we take R minus S as M. Since R is greater than S, R minus S is a positive integer. We call this positive integer as M. This shows that there exists a positive integer M. But is it least? No, we don't know. Therefore, hence if n is the least positive integral value of m, such that a to the power m is equal to e, then order of a is n. Therefore, order of a is finite. So if you choose an element a, and if you assume that two elements are equal, because must be, here we have infinitely many elements, but G is finite, therefore any two elements are equal. If we take any two elements are equal, we arrive at there exists a least positive integer n such that A to the power n is equal to E, that is order of A is n, and hence order of A is finite. This completes the first part of the theorem. Now we have to show that order of any element must be less than or equals to order of the group. Let us choose A, B an arbitrary element. We will show that order of A is less than or equal to order of G. This is the second part of the theorem. If possible, let order of A is greater than order of G. So we have assumed the other way. We are going to get a contradiction. That is, we are going to prove the second part using contradiction. Let us continue. Let A belong to G and the order of A is n. Then by definition, A to the power n is equal to E, where n is the least positive integer. That is, any number which is less than n should not satisfy this condition. When you say n is the least positive integer, there should not be any integer less than n satisfies this condition. Let us see. By closure, we have a square, a power 3, so on, a power n belong to G. We know that G has only finite number of elements. Therefore, let us take a belongs to G, and hence a squared, a power 3, so on, a power n also belong to G by closure property. That is, G has n elements, which is finite. No two of these elements are equal. For impossible, let a to the power r equal to a to the power s, where s and r are from 1 to n, that is any one of these elements, 1 to n, and assume that r is greater than s. Since a to the power s is an element of G, inverse exists, therefore a power minus s is also an element of G, and hence we multiply both sides by a to the power minus s. We get a to the power r minus s equal to a to the power s minus s. We know that s minus s is 0, a power 0 is identity. Therefore, a to the power r minus s is equal to e. That's the one we've done here. Since 0 is less than r minus s, less than n, difference must be less than n. Order of a is less than n, because r minus s, a to the power r minus s is a positive integer which is less than n. So order of a is less than n, which is a contradiction to the fact that order of a is n. We already assumed that the order of a is n, and we stated already that no positive integer less than n should satisfy this. But now there exists a positive integer r minus s which satisfying this condition. Therefore, which is a contradiction. Why this contradiction arises? Because we assume that these two elements are equal. These two elements are equal. Therefore, we have to change our assumption that no two elements are equal. Let us recall the order of minus 1 in the multiplicative group, g equal to 1 minus 1, I minus I. We know minus 1 power 2 is 1, minus 1 power 4 is 1, minus 1 power 6 is 1. That is, minus 1 power any even number is 1. Yes, right. But what is the order of minus 1? Order of minus 1 is 0 or 2 or 4 or 6 or any even integer. It is nothing but 2, because that must be the least positive integer n. So order of minus 1 is 2. So no number less than 2 will satisfy this condition. Same way here, this gives a contradiction. Hence, the n elements a squared, a power 3, so on, a power n are all distinct elements of G. Order of a equal to n is greater than order of g is also not possible. The reason is, a finite group cannot contain elements whose number is greater than the order of the group. Therefore, order of a equal to n cannot be greater than order of g, and hence order of a is less than or equal to order of g. This completes the proof. In a group G, if A belongs to G, then order of A equal to order of A inverse. Let G comma circle be a group. Let order of A is N, order of A inverse equal to M. Now our aim is to show that N is equals to M. Order of A is N. This implies N is the least positive integer such that A power N equal to E. Order of A power minus 1 is M. Since we assume that order of A inverse is M. Therefore, m is the least positive integer such that a to the power minus m is equals to e. Now consider a to the power m. This can be written as a to the power minus m into minus 1. Again, this can be written as a power minus 1 into m power minus 1. Loss of indices. But what is this A inverse power m? A inverse power m is e. That is a power minus 1, m is equal to e minus 1. We know that inverse of identity is itself, so e. Let order of a is n, and if a power m equal to e, where m is positive integer, then n must be less than or equal to m. The reason is, when you say order of a, n is the least positive integer. What is m here? Positive integer. And hence, n must be least. Therefore, n is less than or equal to m. And hence, here we can write, since the order of A is n, and m also satisfies the condition, but what is n? Least. Therefore, n is less than or equal to m. Similarly, start with the another element, a power minus 1. Take the power n. It is equal to a power minus n. It can be written as a power n into minus 1. What is a to the power n? A to the power n is e. A power minus 1 power n, that is equal to a to the power minus n. This can be written as a to the power n into minus 1. What is a to the power n? A to the power n is e. And hence, e power minus 1 inverse of identity is itself, that is equal to e. Thus, the order of a power minus 1 is m, and n also satisfies the condition. N is a positive integer, but m is the least positive integer. And hence, we can write m is less than or equal to n. So from these two, n is less than or equal to m and m is less than or equal to n, this implies n equal to m. Therefore, order of a equal to order of a inverse.